A'udzu billahi minasyaitonir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Afdhalus salati wa tammu taslim ala sayyidina maulana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa sallim tasliman katsira. Subhanaka la ilma illa ma 'allamtana fa'allimna bima yanfa'una wa zidna 'ilman wa 'amalan mutaqabbalan ya rabbal alamin. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina maulana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa sallim tasliman katsira. Amma ba'd. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Satan the accursed, and we begin in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Indeed, all praises, thanks, gratitude, and glorifications are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Lord of all the worlds, and choicest blessings on our beloved and noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected viewers, I greet you with the greetings of peace, the greetings of paradise. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the guidance, the mercies and the blessings and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with each and every one of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, ku anfusakum wa ahlikum nara, wa quduhan nasu wal hijara. Sadaqallahu al-aliyyul azim. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in translation made mention in the Holy Quran, that all you who believe, save yourselves and your families from the punishment of the hellfire, whose fuel is men and stones. My dear respected viewers, this ayah of the Holy Quran, two great companions of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commented on it. One is Sayyidina Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, and the second is Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. And while it has in it the interpretation that we be in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we work righteous deeds, also in this ayah, Sayyidina Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala and Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala and outline that a portion of this ayah, or one of the meaning of this ayah, is the upbringing of our children. And this is what creates barrier between us and the hellfire. When we instill in our children the right adab, the prophetic way, the ways of the Quran, the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we teach them what is right and we ask them to stay away from that which is wrong. They follow the prophetic guidance in their walking, in their speech, in their actions, the way they deal with their families and friends and their neighbors and their associates. This is what the Quranic ayah entails, my dear respected gathering. Because we as parents, we have a responsibility first towards our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then to those who are entrusted to us by our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in this case our family members, whether it be our spouses or our children. And Sayyidina Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala and Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala and is explicitly saying that we teach them to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the right fearing. Teach them to be persons who would follow the commands of Allah and abstain from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made prohibited. My dear respected viewers, we have heard the cries so many times and from so many imams and counselors in our communities, in our society, that the main cry is that the parents keep saying, why is it my children is not adhering to my advice? Why is it why my children is not adhering to the principles of my home, things that we would wish them to adhere to? Why is it my children not raising their hands and making supplication for me? Why are they not reading Quran on my behalf? Why are they not going to the masjid? And this is all, my dear respected gathering, where sometimes we as parents, we fail to fulfill our responsibility towards our children. Yes, we can give our children whatever possible in this life, but we have to remember that we have to teach them not to fear us, but fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when we teach them to fear us, or we teach them to cling to us, or that we are the one who provides the sustenance and the provisions, and it is only us who are doing that, then when we are not there, then they would act contrary to what you have taught them. But when, my dear respected viewers, when we teach them to fear Allah, God Almighty, when we teach them to depend and put their trust only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then, my dear respected viewers, we will find that when we, in our absence, they will remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching them. As our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made mention in one prophetic saying, the hadith that is known as the hadith Jibra'il, the hadith of the archangel Jibra'il, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى فإن لم تكن ترى فإنه يراك. And worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala though you see him, as if you see him. And know that you will not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees us. And that is why in the secret of our home and in the seclusion of our home, when we are inclined or when we are whispered by the devil, Satan, to do something that is prohibited and displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has his angels recording and will bring us to accountability on the day of reckoning, on the day of accountability, my dear respected viewers. And that is why we have a responsibility towards our children. Teach our children to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Teach our children to conduct themselves with the conduct of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Teach our children to be grateful for the bounties and the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon them. Teach our children to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and don't be like those who forget Allah, so Allah caused them to forget themselves. Teach our children to be optimistic and not pessimistic. Teach our children to tread the path of righteousness and guidance. Teach our children to speak the truth. Teach our children to walk in a manner the way the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam walked, my dear respected viewers. And this would help us in the hereafter. This would help us because we are saving ourselves according to the ayah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and save yourselves and your families from the punishment of the hellfire. Teach our children who to associate partners with. Teach them the right upbringing, my dear respected viewers. As our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in one prophetic saying, he said, the parables of those people or companions who are good and righteous, opposed to the companions who are disobedient and those who are leading towards that which is inappropriate and that is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like a person that is carrying musk. A person who is carrying the most sweet-smelling perfume and a person who is like a blacksmith. And he says, if you follow the persons who basically carry musk, the sweet-smelling perfume, that at the end of the day, he will present you with something. And if he doesn't present you with something, you will buy from him a sweet-smelling perfume. And if you do not do the two that I've mentioned before, he says, when you leave that individual, you would at least be smelling beautiful. You would at least, because of handling the perfume, you will come out smelling, feeling and smelling beautifully. But on the other hand, on the opposite side, if you follow the blacksmith, then either your thobe or your garment would be burnt, or you will come out having soot on your body. So my dear respected viewers, we have a responsibility towards Allah. We have a responsibility to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who are in our trust. And in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us that responsibility. Save yourselves and your families from the punishment of the hellfire whose fuel is men and stones. Give them the right upbringing. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we can able, inshallah, to give our children the right upbringing and save our families from the punishment of the hellfire and ourselves. Aqulu qawli hadha. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.